What's up, gang? Good morning. It's gonna be a fun one today. I'm hitting legs right now. I literally just finished uploading the last video. For whatever reason, this one took 4 or 5 different tries to upload and then didn't even let me monetize because of the copyright issues. But it's gonna be a premiere. All of my YouTube videos are premieres. Every time I drop a YouTube video, I'm there watching it with you guys because I want to see you guys and interact with you guys, and I think it's really cool. But I'm finishing my morning coffee. I'm gonna get dressed and then hop in the car because I'm already late. I gotta be there in 15 minutes. So I will see you guys at the gym. We'll say what's up to Jake. And yeah, we just pulled up to the gym. It's time for leg day. We're with the boy Jake.
Yes, sir.
He's gonna be running the VHS cam today. But today's your reminder to push yourself. Give yourself 100% energy. See where the end of your limits are, because without challenge, there is no success. A diamond is not a diamond without pressure. Let's get it, baby. Mama T-Spall is gonna be filming my show, bro. She's the GOAT.
That shit, huh?
I have to pull up to Phoenix 2 days early so that the day before I get spray tan with the first layer and I check in.
Yeah.
Day of, I get second layer and show up on stage.
That's crazy.
Yeah, bro.
That's
I'm fucking pumped.
That's the first time I've ever had that. I don't even know if you can see him.
Yeah, you can see him a little bit.
Yeah.
Ew.
T-Spall first leg veins? Yes, sir.
What's next on the agenda?
Jim got some baddies, bro.
What me and Tommy have fucking done in 1 year is literally gonna be put into the fucking history textbooks, Common Core, Social Studies, fourth grade. They're going to be like, what in the literal fuck? Last year, I flew out to LA, spent almost all of my fucking money to go visit Tommy, and now we're both sponsored by the same fucking companies, doing the same fucking work, going the exact same fucking speed of hardness, determination, passion, fucking everything. We made it fucking happen, bro.
Hey, all that goes to say, me and Baj stuck to a dream and stay consistent. You guys can achieve literally anything that you put your mind to. You just have to believe in yourself. And you have to not give up on the hard days, because there's going to come days where people are going to tell you, like, oh, you're fucking stupid for doing X, Y, and Z, which is just whatever you want to be doing. So just put in the work, bro. I promise you that if you keep your head down and you stay down and you grind, bro, you'll get there. This is the most fun part of the workout. Not actually. It's all body weight stuff because I'm so close to show. Weighted stuff kills me. So we're gonna do body weight squats with a sissy squat drop set. Let's get to it. Big hamstrings, go sprint. Go sprint and work specifically hypertrophy work on your hamstrings. Trust me. It's gonna sound weird, but I'm putting you onto some game.
Just barely.
We getting conditioned, baby. The quad's getting leaner.
Hell yeah.
that's too easy.
Come on, Spalding.
So, just finished the workout. Now, because I'm 17 days out, I have to do cardio every day, religiously, 20 minutes. And it's only gonna increase. I think I'll never do more than 40. But first day back doing cardio. If you guys know me, you know I go live when I do cardio. So the cardio lives will return for the last couple days of prep, the last couple weeks of prep, I should say. And I'm excited for the next battle, the journey ahead, but it's gonna be tough. And I'm gonna need you guys' help. So please do, you know, leave comments. I read every comment. If you don't think I do, I really do. I may not get to liking every single comment, but I read every comment. Now, I've grown to a point where I can't exactly answer every single DM, but I answer as I can and as they come in. So feel free to reach out if you guys need some. Don't expect an answer quick, but I will do my best to get to it. There was a young LA drop today. You guys went fucking crazy. I'm beyond blessed, bro. You guys have changed my life. You guys have changed the way that I train. You guys have changed the way that I live. Like, I get to do this shit full time now, and it's my dream. So, thank you. And it's another drop coming up on Young LA, the 26th. So, Code T-Spawn to support your boy, as always. And I love you, gang. Finished the workout and I did some posing practice at the end. It was nice to see how my shape is kind of filling in. I'm excited to see that more water than I'm losing, better my V shape is, because my lats insert a little bit lower than I thought they did. I just couldn't see it because I thought they were love handles, which is a mind fuck. But I'm excited to go eat. Calories dropped today from 2400 to 2200. Keeping at 200 grams protein, so it is all carbs that I'm losing, which would have been the carbs that I'm having before this workout, like two Rice Krispies, or like a bag of popcorn, or like a bagel. Some quick energy sources. May not sound like a lot, but it definitely does affect your training when you're at a low body fat percentage. At a low body fat percentage, the skin underneath your dermis, so your epidermis, the skin underneath your skin loses fat, and so that's why when we hold on to water weight, it looks like our skin is all stretchy. I just need to lose the last little bit of fat right here and on my legs, and I will be ready for the show. August 5th, and I'm coming for that gold. I'm gonna take first, I hope, in the men's classic novice for class A, which will be my, or class B, which will be for my high class. So, Lord willing, it's all up to God, and I just gotta do me, man. All in God's timing. So I'm gonna go fucking eat because I'm starving, dude. I just got back to my neighborhood, but I forgot that because I dropped calories again because of prep, I have a meal plan that I have to follow to a T now. So I'm gonna go to Target to get some groceries, and then I'm gonna go home and finally eat meal one. I'm exhausted from that workout, though. It was a really good workout. Really, really fun, actually, but I'm more excited to see what Jake does with the editing style, which you guys will have just seen. And Jake's a really cool person. We met through a mutual friend of ours. I'm excited to see what he can do. I'm also excited to see if we're gonna be working together. This life has so much possibility, so much potential. You just have to look for it. You gotta find the people and the environments that are similar to your mindset and work on your goals while others are supporting you in your goals. Try and find a group of 3-4 core people that you can trust, maybe even one or two, and work together with them towards your goals. That's what I do with Tommy Brown. Every night we go for a walk and we talk about our future plans for success, our future plans for business, our merch lines, etc. We just talk about everything. So find your people, bro. I promise that if you're not happy with your current circumstances, odds are that you haven't found the right people yet. So I just registered for my show. I am officially competing in the novice and open divisions for Classic at the Herberger Theater on August 5th. I'm kind of excited. I'm kind of nervous, but I'm ready. I haven't been more ready for anything in my life. Me and Tommy just bought our tickets. Bye. We already got the hotel info, and we got a whole plan for having the boys come, and it's going to be a lot of fun. No matter what the outcome is, I know that I'm going to bring out my best package. There's nothing that's going to stop me from feeling gratified with the best work that I could bring to the table. The Echo guys might come, which would be really sick. Be able to get some really good content from that as well. Today was just chill. After I left the gym and checked in with you guys, I came home, ate a meal, and have been just chilling and sleeping all day because cows dropped, so my energy levels are lower, but allowing yourself the time to rest and be able to have ample rest time is good as well. Letting your body fully recover helps the mind recover. I bought these little dental chew things. They're good for relieving anxiety. I will put the link somewhere, probably my threads. I'll thread it out there for you guys. Yeah, I think that's it for today. I don't think we're walking tonight because we both hit legs, so we're both sore.
Dude, I can't even walk down the stairs.
But I'm gonna go to sleep. I have two more meals to eat. Thank fucking God. I'll see y'all in the morning. What's up, gang? This morning was kind of boring. I didn't really do much. I just kind of chilled in my room all day and then pretty much it. Prep's been kicking my ass, but after resting and getting a meal in, having a cup of coffee, drinking some water, I feel a lot more active. But I'm gonna sit here and edit and upload TikToks and just kind of kick back and relax until bowling tonight. So another bowling vlog is coming at you guys. We are on the way to go bowling and pick up Tommy Brown.
But Robert Irving.
15 days left, baby. 15. And it's showtime.
Yo. Yeah. You some merch?
Oh, you look jacked as fuck in that, actually.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Beach that way.
Shit's sick. I actually really like the way it fits.
So, okay. Gang.
Shit's fine.
They fucking win.
They win.
Winners win.
Regular shoes.
No way.
Look at them all dripped up. Looking with the mom.
It's the young LA for sure.
For show, bro.
Everywhere.
Hey, who's coaching you for that?
Coach Tommy.
Bro, missed and bro messed up and didn't use my code.
Hey, keep the GGG though.
Still keeps me looking good, bro. I could be bowling.
Hey, let me see the bag.
Nice.
Anyways, we're going to the gas station to get like an energy drink or some shit, so we'll be back to go bowling in a moment. Those fools are not locked in on the game plan. I walked in there and I got my water, and now I'm going back because I'm next up to bowl, and we have a game to win.
We've been having to bust the game out quick, but
I'm losing by a lot. So we're also going to a movie tonight, and I'm sorry I didn't film more of the bowling part. Last one was more entertaining. What's up, gang? It is the next day, and I'm headed to the gym. The Barbie movie last night was actually really good, a lot better than I was expecting it to be. Today's stack is Dethroner and some L-Citrulline. I'm not doing a full two scoops of Dethroner because I don't want to be hyper-tweaking in the gym, but gonna go scoop Tommy. We're gonna go hit back, and then I have to come back because I have posing practice for the first time at 3:30 today. We just pulled up Crunch Fitness. Simi Valley, the home gym. We're here to work.
Tommy wanted me to give y'all some motivation. So I'm gonna give you the motivation of you don't fucking need motivation. The whole time we were at the show or we were at the hotel, what was I watching?
I was like watching like Ronnie Coleman edits.
Yep. It was his full like day in life. It's a 3 hour long YouTube video. So he was leg pressing like 2,000-3,000 pounds. And it's just him looking like so normal, like unfazed. And he goes, ain't nothing to do but to do it. That's his life. Ain't nothing to do but to fucking do it. If you want it, ain't nothing to do but to do it.
It's another day.
Just another day.
The first thing I said to him when he opted off stage.
Just another day. After,
you know, like tackling him for getting 3 golds, it was, hey, bro, just another day.
Just another day. Ain't nothing to do but to do it. So get out there and fucking do it.
That's crazy.
Get in here and get this lit. Fuck them tacos. Fuck.
I don't know if you guys can see me or not, but I am almost late. Just barely on time for my first posing practice. Get on video call with the boy CB. I'll let you guys know how it goes. I just finished posing practice, which was so much harder than I thought it was going to be. I'm not gonna lie. I have a lot of work to do, but we're 13 days out and I'm gonna push through. People were leaving like negative comments on my last video, and I normally wouldn't care, but like I'm so close to the show that it's starting to get in my head. But there's no point in even letting it. That's just another reminder that if somebody is trying to make you question yourself, don't. Your goals are going to be a little bit hard to see to other people, but if you do it right and you just stay at it, you got this. You will achieve your goal no matter how hard you try. You're gonna get there. It's the end of the day for me, 7 o'clock, and I think I'm gonna cash out early tonight. I might take a nap and then wake up and go do cardio, walk around Tommy's neighborhood with him. 13 days left. I'm not nervous as much anymore, but I'm excited and I'm ready for it to be over. Even though it's only gonna get harder from here, I'm just ready to be able to eat again and be able to actually enjoy what I do. So for the next essentially 2 weeks, I just have to lock back in. I just have to lock in. Well, I've been locked in, but I mean, I have to lock in like really hardcore, and I don't think it's necessarily going to be difficult for me, but I do think that I'm going to encounter problems that I didn't think I would have to. I have to be really ready for anything when it comes to like stepping up on stage, getting ready for prep, if I show up too watery, if I show up overspilled. So lots of thoughts, lots of things to consider, but as long as I stay true to the meal plan and don't fuck up on my cardio or my eating or my water drinking or anything, then I'll likely come out on top. I've been doing a lot of practice when it comes to holding my breath during the poses and stuff, so I can actually stand being on stage that long and posing for that long. I think the number one thing that's important to me though is showing my best package. It would be really nice to win and it would feel really gratifying to win, but it's not what I'm there for. I'm there to show up and do my best. So I think that that's the number one lesson that I want you guys to learn from this prep is, if you're watching out there, just do your best. Your best sometimes isn't going to be good enough, and sometimes it's going to be more than needed. But just do your best. Do your best in everything so that people will never say that you lived half-heartedly. But with that being said, gang, I love you guys. Please take care. Stay blessed. Have a blessed day, night, or evening wherever you're at. I love you, and I will see you in the next video.